take three key ahadith, and of course above that the Quran itself. When the Quran speaks about ahilla, there are people also interpreted different ways. Ahilla to be seen, or that it's a metaphor also of the beginning of the month of fasting. But something that we need to be clear in our minds, that any claim that calculation is bid'ah or contra sunnah is answered in the Quran itself. In Surah Al-Rahman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الشمس والقمر بحسبان, that the sun and the moon follow a specific and accurate calculation. حسبان is calculation. But you know, some linguists also said that the word حسبان is more eloquent, more intensive than حساب. حساب means calculation. حسبان means very meticulous calculation. This is exactly what the astronomers can tell you today. This is not an area of debate. People can debate the degree of accuracy or definitiveness of citability or citing even for itself. But nobody today ever debate the issue of the exact word husban that the Quran speaks about, that is the astronomical new moon. 100 years from now, 1,000 years from now, it's a matter of a few seconds, if any, and it could be because of our calculations. Yeah. But it is so accurate and so clear that there is no question about it. Citability is dependent on clouds, on other factors like the angle in which the crescent appears in the horizon. It could be there, but because it's slower, you cannot see it because of this, the shape of the earth. There's no argument about that. So there is no contradiction with the definitive science, not probabilistic. No contradiction between that and what the Quran says, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who sent us or revealed His Sharia to us, is the same Lord who created the heavens and earth and ordained that it follow certain delicate calculation. So let me, beyond the Quran, there is no evidence in the Quran, definitive one way or the other, that if one say this opinion is out, un-Islamic or un-Quranic. We find argument, people refer to the Quran also and make both arguments.